right. See ya.
See ya, Alex.
All right. Hiking into the woods. It's really hard to hike with all this weight. Also trying not to sink in the snow. But at the same time, I want to get far away from this highway because I don't want people seeing some crazy guy hiking into the forest with a bunch of sleeping bags. I'm out of breath. Taking a little breather here. It's nice. Even if I was in shape, that would have been a hard hike. Also, the only thing I'm using to film this is my iPhone. I've got no backup battery, no nothing. So I have to make this charge last for the entire night. So I'm gonna be very selective as to what I'm filming here. And I've only got a couple more, well, a few more hours of daylight left, so, but it's gonna go by fast, so I have to get moving. Gotta get working on this shelter. The first step is find a campsite. I think I'm gonna look for maybe a little bit of a valley, so I'm kind of hidden. And then the second step, collect as much wood as humanly possible. I think this is a frozen stream. The deer are using it as a path. So if I set up around here, I'll probably hear deer walking by in the middle of the night. I'm sure that'll freak me out. There is some precipitation, so good thing I brought this tarp. I'm just gonna put all my sleeping stuff on top of and underneath the tarp for now while I build the shelter. And here's what I'm gonna use to build. I don't really need the saw because there is a serrated edge on the back of this knife, but you know, why not? Some trees may have to die in the making of this video. Time to get to work. Enough talking. So as you can see, what I'm doing here is I'm just collecting as much dead wood as I can find and then stripping them of their branches. The branches I'll use for firewood, and then the bigger logs I'm going to use for the shelter. Collecting all the twigs, putting them in a pile over here. I really should have come out here earlier. There's not that much time in the day left. So, gotta keep moving. I wanna make sure I'm not sweating out here, so it's time to disrobe. So it's around 2 p.m. I'm in Haliburton County, Muskoka area, Northern Ontario. This is all I have so far for the shelter, and that's all I have so far for the fire. So we've got a lot more firewood and a lot more shelter building material to collect. I'm gonna focus on that for a little while, and I'll set up the camera again when I'm actually installing the lean-to. I'm also clearing the twigs off the trees that are in the vicinity of my campsite so that I don't poke myself in the eye. Wow. Okay. Well, I definitely broke Les Stroud's number one rule. I'm sweating my bag off. Good news, though. No trees had to die in the making of this video. They're pretty much already all dead. I've begun constructing the lean-to. I've got a starter pile of wood here. Reserve pile there. Not nearly enough, but it's a good start. It was really hard to find the perfect branches, though, for these joints here. We've got one on this side and one over there holding it up. I wanted to make a little bed in there, but I don't think I have time, so might be sleeping on that tarp tonight. It's okay, the fire will keep me warm. We're getting there. Time is not quite on my side today. I should have been out here at the crack of dawn, but it is what it is. Ideally, I would like to build up some walls on either side. I should build at least one, but if I don't get around to both, at least I've got a tarp over there that I might drape over top of the entire shelter just to add a little bit extra wind blockage. I'd like to zip these all off right at the crossbar there, make it look a little more aesthetically pleasing, but it is what it is. Maybe some hiker will stumble upon it and wonder what the hell went down here. Civilization does lie not very far in that direction, hence the orientation of my shelter and my fire. I'm trying to sort of block out any flames that could be visible. Probably going to be cooking dinner in the dark tonight, but that's all right. I got a couple flashlights in my bag and we'll have a nice rip roarer going. So yeah, ramen and pork cutlet for dinner. And now I'm gonna go walk around and try and find more side posts. Block out some of that draft coming in. Okay guys, so I threw together this little platform. This is what we're having for dinner tonight. Pork cutlet on the skillet and ramen. Got a couple of hard-boiled eggs in here, some spinach, and got a nice Japanese style tea kettle here too that I might boil up some tea with. The bed is set up. Got a fire going. Looks a bit derelict, but hey, if it blocks you from the wind. I would have liked to use some pine branches to drape over the back. That would have looked nice and more natural than a big blue tarp, but time to collect more wood. Let's go look for some wood. Wood, wood, wood. It's all we need. One thing's for sure, if you ever were in a survival situation like this, there's no way you could waste any time filming it. Whew. All right. Well, that's about as much energy as I'm able to spend on the shelter tonight. I'm just going to have to rely on my sleeping bags and blankets and extra clothing to keep me warm. And then I got the warmth from the fire on this side. The rest of the night is going to be dedicated to collecting firewood because I would like to keep this fire going as long as I can tonight. It burns the wood faster than I'm able to collect it, so it's difficult. I'm probably just going to let it burn down and spend the next hour or two foraging as hard as I can so that I can keep the fire going as long as I can tonight. It's like 5:30 p.m. right now, but it will be dark very soon, so I gotta get moving, gotta get my firewood. Pretty dark out here. Still foraging. Time to start preparing ramen. I heated it up a little bit earlier just to melt the snow, but now we're gonna get it boiling. I don't have a lid for it, unfortunately. I'm not sure where it is. And we're gonna heat up the skillet. Probably gonna be eating a little bit of ash tonight, but that's okay. There we go. Took me all day to get this bed of coals going. Okay, that skillet should be nice and hot now. Let's throw some oil in there. Okay, pork cutlet going in. So before coming out here, I pre-hard boiled some eggs. So I'm gonna go ahead and peel those. But before I do that, I'm gonna throw these noodles in. Fire is starting to die down on me a little bit, but I think the coals that are directly underneath this pot and pan are still pretty hot. Okay, there we go. That's the sizzle I was looking for. Just had to shuffle the coals around a little bit. Okay, so probably gonna need two hands for this, but I'll show you the finished product. There it is. Not the prettiest thing in the world, but man, it looks good. Smells good too. Okay, let's give it a try. Man, that's good. Not quite the same without chopsticks, but I'm not complaining. I gotta put the phone down and enjoy this. Thanks for watching though. I'm gonna enjoy my ramen and spend a couple more hours getting firewood because the fire's out now. So, sayonara. Arigato.
I miss Mariko.